Dear TJ Omega, please find enclosed an assortment of our garbage Pail Kids lines, including our upcoming MiniKins figure line. These are blind bags. I don't review blind bags. I do the Transformers and import toys. Why would they send me blind bags? Yes, we know you only review Transformers and import toys. That's why we're sending these to you. Fondest regards, the Topps Trading Card Company. Okay, I see. I will pick up that gauntlet. Let's see what you got. I'm actually gonna need this. So that's basically what happened in a nutshell. The Topps Trading Card Company decided to send me a bunch of Garbage Pail Kids merchandise, including these, which are their new MiniKins minifigure line blind bag. Interesting. And I had the exact same reaction you saw in the video. Really? Are you sure? Like, this is so far out of my wheelhouse. I've never done anything blind bag or Garbage Pail Kid related. But I got to thinking, like, they sent these things that are not released, they're not even out until the 16th, to someone who is known for ripping apart bad toys. That's confidence. And if they're that confident, I want to know what they're confident about. So, you figure, okay, what could it hurt? Besides, it's nice and random, it keeps you guys guessing, and it seemed like a good bit of fun just to do something a little bit different. And as these are blind bags, you will notice I am not scripting this review, and I will attempt to make as few edits as possible to preserve the kind of surprise and fun of opening these things up and getting the live reaction to them. Now, I want this to be as clean as it can when you're talking about Garbage Pail Kids, let's put it that way. So, we're not cutting away. Unless I come up with some joke, and I'll add it in. But as long as you see these hands and these bags, this is a live shot, my live reaction. I have not pre-rehearsed these. I have not even seen these things outside of pictures online. And of course, not out till October 16th, so it's impossible for me to have any previous experience with them. That said, this is going to come off very Ashens. I do apologize, but I'm a fan of his videos. He does blind bags a lot, and he does them very well. So, with the assurance that I do not own a blowtorch, we will begin. And I thought the best place to begin was with some of the other stuff they sent me. Namely, these. These are the Garbage Pail Kids Chrome series of cards, which are reprints from the original run of 1985 cards. This is how Garbage Pail Kids got started. Just these really weird Cabbage Patch Kid kind of parody designs. But they're not Cabbage Patch Kids because Mattel got really mad, but they still kind of were. I mean, what else would you describe him? This is Adam Bomb, by the way. If you've probably noticed, they really like Adam Bomb. And, of course, he's the one everyone wants, and go take a look at the original card's price on eBay sometime to see how popular he was. Yeah, Garbage Pail Kids was one of those weird, random, gross-out series from the 80s that took off huge, and they made these things forever, and they made a ton of things. But it started with the cards, so let's see what the original cards were like, with the addition of chrome, which I assume is hollow foil. Yep, it is. There we have, we have Nasty Nick, Jolton Joel, who I think I actually saw in an Ashens video when he was opening the original Garbage Pail Kids card. This is not helping my ripoff defense at all. Tommy Tomb, creepy. Then Duncan. Okay, that's repetitive. Yeah, but that's basically what they were. You can see these just really weird out there. There's a Rob Liefeld as a child design. Yeah, you can see they're just weird, kind of deformed, gross-out kind of things. and little funny things on the back, like little busybody license, slob award, which, yeah, that's the one that used to be on the original card. So, yeah, much nicer print quality than the original cards, but, yeah, that's basically what Garbage Pail Kids always started at. Just kind of wanted to go through these extra cards they sent me real quick, just so you can kind of see what they were about back then, just in case you weren't familiar with Garbage Pail Kids before. Junk Food John, okay. Nerdy Norman, ooh, that's taboo. Kids don't do that. Prickly Pete, prototype Sonic the Hedgehog, and Grape Six. Not quite sure I get that. Raisin. Oh, he's a raisin. Oh, okay. I think. Yeah. There are some, which these aren't, apparently, yeah, Lost Garbage Pail Kids designs. These were not published back then. They are published now. But yeah, these are original ones. They made these back in the day. Again, I saw him in a Nash's vid. This is not helping me. But that's basically what it was. These really gross out little designs. And they made tons of things. You know, they made buttons. They made little minifigures back then. You know, they made stickers. There was a cartoon. There's a movie, which you probably remember for better or worse. And they decided to revive them in the modern day. And we have new Garbage Pail Kids cards. Adam again. Adam really gets around, doesn't he? So, snip, snip, snip. Get off my table. And let's just quickly see what we got in here. Oh, come on! Jeez. I wonder if there's hollow foils in these, too. I'm really hoping for a Blue Eyes White Dragon out of these. And there's... Ah, there we go. See, we have Pauline Puddin, who's a severed head. Oh, my God. Goldilocks went wrong. These are actually sticker cut, too. So this is another kind of throwback to the old stuff. Etched Eric, Surf's Up Chuck, you. Chocolate Bonnie, who's cannibalistic. Melt Tin. Garbage Pail Kids. Oh, Refold. Oh, it's like customizable Garbage Pail Kid. Ooh, that's different. Hey! We got the Flower Power version of Adam. That's... Okay. That's different. That's politically correct. Well, I got an atom bomb, so that's good. Leap, ew. Lucky, no. Water and Welch. Oh, see? Don't. Really? Where's Cabbage Patch Kids now? Jeez. Jeez, and this one didn't even cut, so yeah. I'm not having the best luck opening cards today, am I? Alright. What do we got? I should mention on the back, these have the same kind of... Whoa! Actually, it looks like there's like a customizable... Or like a... Yeah, there's a put-together picture. Like a big one. There were, the original thing of Garbage Pail Kids was based on, Wacky Packages, I believe it was called. Which were like cereal packages and things. They were also really gross-out stuff and parody. So, it looks like on the back of the new cards, there's some of these cards actually had the old, yeah, the old certificate thing on the back, but then you get little comics, too. There's Nasty Ned again. And little bits of what I assume is going to be one of those posters. Let's see, we got Chalky Chester, Luan Luan, ooh, Booger Barak, Pick, Drummond Dennis, Licky Mickey, Gekiu, Falls Apart, ooh, Tetris, okay, creepy, I like it, Shad Owl, Delivery Roy, Doug Plug, okay, I'm sorry, Doug Plug, it's a fire hydrant with a face, I don't know, and then we have Ill Jill. So Garbage Pail Kids still doing what they were doing in the 80s, still kind of rolling out everything, and branching out a lot. There's candy now. Isn't that the face you want to see when you're about to dive in to some delicious gummy candy with magnetic cards? Yeesh, you can put Garbage Pail Kids everywhere. Ooh, I got a severed foot and a gummy eye. Of course it'd be gross out stuff. But yeah, Ghastly Ashley, we got the one on the cover. Sun Bernie, Breezy Betty, ew, Shave, and Not To Be, ew. You're not supposed to use your own skull, Toby. Okay. Now it's a mess. All right. All that aside. So that's basically what... If you've never seen Garbage Pail Kids before, well, you're lying because I just showed you. So that gives us a nice little bit of establishment, and now we can get into the meat. The MiniKins, minifigures, and blind bags. Add them on the cover again. See what we got on the back. Rare blue, red, green, and ultra-rare yellow figures. This is kind of cool because the original minifigure line they had in the 80s were cheap toys, and they came in those four colors. So it's a nice little retro thing and a chase variant thing, which gives you, if I did the math right, like 130 combinations. That's a lot. But here we have our assortment, and you can see they're all over the place. There's Nasty Nick. We saw him in the cards. Dead Ted, Atom Bomb, of course Atom, TV Stevie, Crow to Carl, Creepy Carol, Brainy Janie, Anna Banana, Buggy Betty, Michelle Muck, Mark Bark, Spacey Stacy, who I actually recognize from the old Garbage Pail Kids cartoon. It actually didn't air in America, but I screened the first episode for TJTV. I only made it through one episode. And considering I made it through five of Tattoo Teenage Alien Fighters from Beverly Hills, I'll let you determine what that means. Cracked Jack, Russell Muscle, let's see, Leaky Lindsay, I think I know her. Cyclops, Doug Plug, we really made one of Doug? Okay. Patty Putty, Eerie Eric, Bony Tony, who I remember the card. That was one of my favorites because, oh my god, is it creepy. I'm not lying, I really want that one. Richie Rich, Nat Nerd, who I also recognize from the cartoon. Stan Alive, Huns, oh, it's 80s cheese. DJ, Salty Sean, and Fiery Francis. Considering these things are only an inch tall, I kind of question making one look like a snack pretzel. Let's see, ages 6 and plus. Okay, yeah, by that age, I think they are smart enough not to put anything in their mouth that immediately looks like food. So, that's what we're going for. Let's see, what do we really want out of this? Well, of course, yeah, we want Atom Bomb, Bony Tony, yeah, want him. And TV Stevie, I actually really like the design on TV Stevie, too. I think the only one I really want to avoid is Doug Plug there. I don't know, that one just doesn't seem as creative as the others. Alright, so, our first experience, my first experience with these things. So, we zip down, and let's see what we got here. And let's see, whoa! Bright neon green, and not camera-friendly to design. Let's see, which one is this? This is Dead Ted. This is a green nuclear zombie. So, yeah, it's a nuclear apocalypse that brings on the zombie apocalypse. I figured it would end that way. I always did. Let's see the one we got painted, which is Cyclops. That's a pretty basic design, really. Yeah, he looks like a Cyclops Cabbage Patch Kid with a diaper. Like I said, these things are only about an inch tall, so I'm going to be a little bit more forgiving when it comes to paint apps. And, you know, given the size, it's actually not bad. You can see he's got all three colors to his eyes. It's not overpainted. I'm actually quite surprised. I didn't think they'd be that well painted. Now, it's a, you know, the molding's a little bit crude, but actually got all the details in there. You can see all these little fingers and, you know. All the little details are right. Yeah. I'm actually quite surprised. That's actually better than I expected it to be. They're squishy, too. They're squishy. Let's see. Oh! And we have a bouncing baby boy. Congratulations. Let's see. And got their little stickers, too. Yeah, and Dead Ted and Cyclops. So I wonder if that's how they come. Do you always get one of the rare variants? Now, if I remember the rare right, I believe the ratio is like blue and red are 1 in 3, green is 1 in 4, and the yellows are 1 in 12, if my research stands to reason. So, yeah, the green one's actually a little bit rarer than the others. Alright, so let's see now. Let's see if we can't get a yellow one. Now, I'm going to kind of open up all the rest of these kind of quickly, so, and then we'll just look at them once they're all opened. For a little bit of fun at home, guess to see how many chase figures I get, if I get a yellow one at all, and how many duplicates I get. Yes, I'm aware that adds absolutely no fun to this viewing experience, but I don't think that will stop some of you from lying about your results. So, we'll go through these and kind of crack them open quickly. Ooh, here we go. See, we got... Stan alive. And, yep, there's DJ and rare yellow! Yay! Alright, let's crack open the rest. We'll go over them once all are out, and we'll kind of compare. There, look at the colored ones, because the yellow ones are not cooperative. Oh, hey, look! We got Dead Ned in his proper colors! So I can actually show him to you now. That doesn't count as a duplicate, by the way. Oh, and there's TV Stevie in the blue variant. Alright, next up. Stuck! I'm trying not to look at the stickers. The stickers spoil the surprise. Oh! There we go. We got TV Stevie again, colored this time. Let's see, what else we got? Ooh. Oh, see, which one is that one? It's blue, I think, where are you? It's Creepy Carol. Okay, yeah, it looks like a little Frankenstein girl with the bolts sticking out of her head. Okay, last pack. Let's zip open. You see? I got the ape girl. Let's see. What was her name? Anna Banana. Alright, and who is left? Corroded Carl. Jeez. So, no duplicates aside from the variants, and I don't count those. Jeez. Alright, so, let's get this cleaned up here, and we will take a closer look at some of these. Well, first, let's get this out of the way. There's Dead Ted in his proper zombie appearance. See, now I can start my army. I wish I had like a lot of these and just like line them up on shelves. There's a zombie apocalypse happening on my bookcases. But yeah, I'd say well molded, well designed. He's really creepy. The one eye left over, and then this one really doesn't need a whole lot of paint, does he? There's a little splatter, and yeah, he looks like a zombie. You don't even have to get the eye right on him. And there's Stan alive. He's actually not bad. You know, it's a really cheesy name, but they got the silver right. The expression looks good. All the lines are molded on the ball nicely. Yeah, even a little, you can see the cut in his shirt. At least you could if the light wasn't so glaring. But, you know, I'm hard-pressed to find little complaints. For one little inch tall guys, these are actually really good representations of the Garbage Pail Kids. I feel like I'm getting a disease holding Carl. Here's one of the ones we are really after. There's TV Stevie. Look at that. He's been watching a little too much. Though his design is quite outdated now, isn't it? You need a flat screen TV Stevie now. He's got a little remote in his hand too. Again, it doesn't need too many details, but what's there is well painted. It's well molded. I can see everything very clearly. I can tell what they're going for. That's the important thing. Oh, getting the blue chase figure feels like I only got the unpainted version of this one. Still, actually, in a weird way, you can actually see the details better on the blue one. Let's see, what else we got? Oh, we got the chase ones. So, there we see DJ in his bright yellow. I got a yellow rare, and it's so freaking bright, I can't really get the details on the camera. Oh, boy. The details there, though, he's really one of the more basic designs. He just has a turntable for the top half of his skull. So, not a whole lot to him. You got our Franken girl there. Who, her expression is cute, but then she's very mutated and deformed. And she has bolts sticking out of her head, which is always weird. And then there's Anna Banana, which I begin to wonder if she is actually a girl who is part ape or an ape who is part human. And the question will keep me up all night. Okay, so that is the assortment, and I can't really show them off here because, didn't really plan this part out really well, did I? So, hey, get up. Hey, all you, stand up, stand up, stand up. Up. Okay, stand up or sit down. Stand up or sit. There we go. So, And that's not a bad assortment. There's a lot, you know, a lot there, and I do kind of like the assortment. And really, I like to find things to complain about, but they really didn't do such a bad job. And that would be the end of our look at these, except it's not. See, remember how I told you that I didn't actually ever see these things in person before? I kind of lied about that. See, aside from the two packs I've been showing off, they also sell these packs of four, where one is already visible. There we see Nasty Nick, whose card we saw earlier. So, yeah, we're going into overtime now. I've got two of these, and I swear to God, that's it. I'm out of them at this point. And, again, I promise you, I did not open any of these up in advance to kind of pre-screen them. This is all done on the spot, I swear to God. Because I want a genuine response here. Which, good. See, to get this translucent window, this is actually quite see-through. That I was actually quite worried that you'd actually be able to see which ones you were getting. But nope, they double-bagged them to protect them. Okay, that's smart. And something else I wanted to add. Because the designs on Garbage Pail Kids are all so different and unique, I thought they'd be really easy to feel out through the bags. And, like, I'll be bluntly honest with you. When I was feeling these bags before, I could have sworn I got a Doug plug. No, it was her I was feeling. So, in reality, the weird designs actually kind of counter it, because even though it's all unique, you can't really tell what your hand is touching. It's really hard to actually define the shapes. Okay, so, I got Nick outlets. Careful, this is a tight fit on these, so I don't even know the ratio for the four packs, so let's see what we got here. Oh no! Oh no! Chalk one up to the duplicate pile. Still, out of this many, only one duplicate. That's not bad. And it's one of the more common. It's in the commons anyway, so it's not bad. See, we got Brainy Janie, and we got another variation of Anna Banana. So here, let's set those aside, and we got one more to open. And we will start by cutting out our little Dragon Boy. Snip, 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 snip. Open up. Yeah, if you thought you could feel through the normal bags, yeah, try double bag. Yeah, you've got no chance. So, well protected. Let's see what we got here. And, let's see. I get my little cheat sheet here. Yep. We got a blue chase gnat nerd. We got a Mark Bark, and, let's see, Salty Sean, in another bright green that's really hard to show. So, yeah, if that really was brown and only had the eyes painted in, I'd be really worried about leaving that around if there's a snack bowl in my house. Also, can he even stand? No. So we have to prop him up in the back. Okay, so let's see what else. Let's see what we got here. There's Nasty Nick. Yeah, there's really not much that can go wrong on that design. It's just some white paint on the black figure. It's nicely molded. I can tell what's cloth and everything, and you've got the Widow's Peak, and everything seems kind of well crisp and painted. So that works. Yeah, and we got we got him. We know him already. Stand up, Nick. Stand up, DJ. The definitive nerd. He's like a superhero nerd. Pants on the outside and everything. Like Quail Man. Except not as cool. Let's see, and then Brainy Janie. Again, bright green! And I actually really like the design on her. It's creepy. She's still got the hair over the brain, which is kind of making it even creepier. I don't know why. There's Anna Banana. We've seen her. We've seen her in the red. Mark Bark, who is a dog boy. Focus. Yeah. Now, he's probably got one of the more complicated paint designs going on. He still pulls it off well. Really, like, for a 1-inch tall figure, I really didn't expect the paint to actually be that good. But, yeah, I'm actually quite happy with that. So, yeah, plop you down right there. And our last one is Fiery Francis, who's got a bit of a gas leak. You know what's worse than a fire-breathing dragon? dragon that breathes fire from both ends. So, neat little dragon guy, though. I like that. And, of course, all of these came with all their little stickers and everything. So, you get this nice little arrangement, and you can actually see what they're supposed to look like if they came in a color too bright to see. So, that seems to be it. I swear, this time I'm done. But that is our look at the MiniKins line. I can get enough of them actually in shot. Yeah, I'm actually surprised with how good these came out. Like I said, I had no real prior experience to these outside of the ones I could see in the package. And I'm actually quite happy with the results. I mean, they're very well detailed, the molding is good, and the paint is actually really passable for something that small. There we go. I wish you'd see the zombie. So, yeah, I'm actually quite a fan. I didn't get an atom bomb, so clearly I'm not done here. I didn't get Bony Tony either. This is annoying. I had like 18 shots, and I missed all of them. Well, I got two TV Stevies, so I guess that's something. So yeah, these things are coming back in force. They're doing they've got a YouTube channel up right now, which I'm going to link in the description, and I'll probably put an annotation right here, as I am contractually obligated to do. But it is a decent channel. They've got some, right now it's only got some commercials up for these new lines, but they are doing a mini-series. They are doing a web series for these guys. And the commercials are funny, and the web series is done by the same guys, so I'm kind of looking forward to that. I will admit, I went in very skeptical of this, but I'm actually quite pleased with the results. They are very nice little representations of the old Garbage Pail Kids. There's a lot to like in the retro quality of the neon figures, as well as the modern quality of the painted ones. Yep, all around. This is worthy to pick up if you're a fan. So, yeah, there's a lot to look into for these guys, so check it out if you're interested. And who knows, I might just dive into this again later on. Is it so bad that I just want a boy who peels his own face off? Really, it's all I want out of life. Isn't it what we all want?